Mother Nature wants to kill you. You already know many of the ways that can happen. Earthquakes, hurricanes, tornadoes, volcanoes, and avalanches are common enough. But with a little warning and preparation, you can survive those. Tsunamis are certainly among the worst, as they can inflict mass casualties and there is little defense against it. Even so, it usually doesn't kill everybody. What if I told you there was a rare type of natural disaster that killed nearly everything in the immediate area? There is no chance to run and nowhere to hide. Death arrives silently and without warning. Unfortunately, it is very real. Surprise, you're dead. On October 15, 1984, in Cameroon, Africa, some people driving on a road near Lake Monoun made a horrifying discovery. They found 37 people lying on or near the road, and all of them were dead. When authorities began investigating, they suspected a massacre. After realizing the victims weren't murdered, they next suspected an infectious disease. Witnesses informed investigators that they heard rumbling noises, then saw a white cloud rise from the lake. They also claimed to smell sulfur. The authorities thought that perhaps a volcanic eruption happened. The gases from that eruption could have suffocated the victims. The truth may never be known for certain, but some scientists have made an educated guess. Lake Monoun is in a volcanic crater and it is very deep. On the day of the disaster, part of the crater collapsed and caused a landslide. When the landslide hit the bottom, it forced carbon dioxide to be released from the surface of the lake. The gas is heavier than oxygen, so it sinks to the ground and displaces it. It is also odorless. The 37 people who died suffocated without warning. Lake Nyos is another deep lake located in a volcanic crater. It is also in Cameroon, though over 200 miles from Lake Monoun. On the night of August 21, 1986, Lake Nyos experienced a landslide. It released thousands of tons of carbon dioxide into nearby areas. The gas suffocated over 1,700 people, and it reached as far as 16 miles. Wildlife, cattle, and even insects were killed in large numbers. Even plants on the edge of the lake were destroyed. The landslide caused a tsunami, which ripped vegetation from the ground. Survivors. Although most people died, some did survive, and as you might expect, natural disasters can cause mental health issues. When people experience a traumatic natural event, their first reaction is a combination of fear and distress. Even after the event has passed, it isn't uncommon for those who lived through it to experience extreme stress and anxiety. Unsurprisingly, alcohol and drug abuse is a common response too. It isn't hard to see why. Can you imagine falling unconscious unexpectedly only to awake and find that your child has died? It happened to Joseph Nguyen. He survived the event at Lake Nyos and explained what happened. "I could not speak. I became unconscious. I could not open my mouth because then I smelled something terrible. I heard my daughter snoring in a terrible way, very abnormal. When crossing to my daughter's bed, I collapsed and fell. I was there till 9 o'clock in the morning, until a friend of mine came and knocked at my door. I was surprised to see that my trousers were red, had some stains like honey. I saw some starchy mess on my body. My arms had some wounds. I don't really know how I got those wounds. I opened the door. I wanted to speak. My breath would not come out. My daughter was already dead. I went into my daughter's bed, thinking that she was still sleeping. I slept till it was 4:30 in the afternoon. Then I managed to go over to my neighbors' houses. They were all dead. I decided to leave. I got my motorcycle. A friend whose father had died left with me. As I rode through Nyos, I didn't see any sign of any living thing." Many of the survivors described smelling sulfur and had lesions on their skin. The victims insisted they were exposed to dangerous gases other than carbon dioxide. The doctors who treated them thought the smells might have been imagined. Apparently, carbon dioxide poisoning can cause hallucinations. The lesions appeared to be pressure sores, which occur when the body is deprived of oxygen. Furthermore, if the victims were really exposed to hydrogen or sulfur, they would have had burning pains in the eyes or nose. So, in addition to finding all their friends and family dead, the survivors couldn't even trust their memories. What is this cruel natural disaster that strikes without warning? How does this happen? And can anything be done about it? Limnic Eruptions. A limnic eruption is a natural disaster which occurs when dissolved carbon dioxide erupts from a lake. It forms a gas cloud that sinks over the surrounding area, killing everything which breathes. Lakes are a common but very temporary feature, geologically speaking. Most of them only last a few thousand years, whereas rivers and oceans can measure their lifespans in the millions. This is due to the way lakes form. Compared to rivers and oceans, their waters are relatively calm. Sediments in the water eventually fall to the bottom and are deposited there. Over time, the bottom of the lake rises as sediments are deposited. If this follows its natural course, then within a few thousand years, the lake may be gone entirely. Mostly, it depends on how deep the lake is. Some lakes that are near volcanoes form in craters that are very deep. And because they form in a crater, the lowest parts of the lake are under high pressure. The bottom part of the lake is also very cold. This allows carbon dioxide and possibly other volcanic gases to build up in the bottom layers. Lake Nyos, for instance, is 311 feet deep, or about 95 meters. Lake Monoun is 682 feet deep, or 208 meters. Sometimes a tsunami can arise from the violence of gas escaping. As the carbon dioxide escapes, the water is lifted, which in turn allows more gas to escape. When the water returns to the lake, it does so with enough force to create destructive waves. One feature of lakes that possess the ability to kill in this manner is they must be meramictic. This means that the lake has stratified layers of water that do not mix. When something happens that causes the layers to mix, that is when a dissolved gas can be suddenly released. The triggers which can cause this are numerous. Landslides, as mentioned previously, are one way to force this to happen. Earthquakes can cause it too, as well as rainstorms and strong wind. Once the layers of water start to mix and the carbon dioxide begins to escape, it becomes a runaway reaction that can't be stopped. The good news is most lakes on Earth are holomictic. This means that the top and bottom layers of water mix regularly. Now there are three known lakes that can generate limnic eruptions, and all three are in Africa. These are Lake Nyos and Lake Monoun, and Lake Kivu. Lake Kivu is on the border of Rwanda and Democratic Republic of the Congo. Studies of these sediments have shown that it has an eruption roughly every 1,000 years and kills everything around it. Of course, since lakes come and go all the time, they have appeared elsewhere throughout Earth's history. In Messel, Germany, for instance, fossils were discovered which seemed to have been created by a degassing event. The event was far in the past, so Germans don't have to be worried. It last happened 56 million years ago. Scientists were still learning about this phenomenon in the 1980s. Today, it may be possible to prevent lakes from degassing. Solutions. When a limnic eruption does occur, the process is very similar to what happens when you open a carbonated beverage. Once you open the bottle, carbon dioxide is dissolved in the liquid under high pressure. When the container is opened, it suddenly releases. Of course, soft drink bottles only contain a small amount of carbon dioxide. The eruption at Lake Nyos released about 1.6 million tons of it. Although this may seem like a lot, it is only a problem because it arrives suddenly in a low-lying area. The United States alone released 5.27 billion tons of carbon dioxide into the atmosphere in 2017. Clearly, people around the world aren't suffocating to death because of it. Are they suffocating slowly instead? We'll cover that in a future episode. The good news is, since scientists now understand limnic eruptions, they can do something to help prevent them. They can't stop carbon dioxide from coming out of the lake bottom, but they can engineer a solution that does it in a controlled manner. In 1990, a team led by French scientist Michel Alvax began experimenting at Lake Nyos and Lake Monoun. They installed pipes pointing down into the lake, with the top of the pipe rising a few feet above the surface. This allowed gas to escape continuously without turning into a runaway event. In January 2001, a single pipe was installed in Lake Nyos. In 2011, United Nations funding allowed for the installation of two more. By 2006, Lake Monoun also had three pipes. The three pipes were thought to be enough to prevent the lakes from erupting again. Installing a few pipes helps, but as a long-term solution, it has downsides. At the lowest levels of the lakes, the high levels of carbon dioxide also mean the water is acidic, so pipes and other equipment degrade quickly and require constant maintenance. It isn't cheap to keep the systems running. In 2003, a project was approved to fully degas Lake Monoun. Within 18 months, the project was complete, so it is possible to eliminate the danger of limnic eruptions, but it is costly too. Lake Kivu and Lake Nyos have not been completely degassed, but thanks to the pipes, they are probably safe. More accurately, they are safe as long as the systems are maintained. Also, are the Great Lakes a danger? Lake Superior is 1,332 feet or 406 meters deep. Lake Michigan is 925 feet or 282 meters. That's deeper than Lake Nyos, Lake Monoun, or Lake Kiva. Could they suddenly experience a degassing event? For the moment, scientists think not. For one thing, the lakes are spread over a greater area. Furthermore, they are not located near volcanoes, and it appears to some extent their waters do mix. Lake Michigan, for instance, seems to burp carbon dioxide every fall. If scientists are wrong, though, and the Great Lakes ever did experience a limnic eruption, the results would be catastrophic. Around 32 million people currently live in the Great Lakes Basin. Although limnic eruptions are rare and the odds are you will never be near one, there is a more important lesson to be learned from them. Even with modern technology and all the wonders of science, we still can't know what the next disaster will be. Should you be constantly worried because you can't know when it will come or defend against it? Or is there no point worrying since you can't do anything about it? We can't tell you how to feel, but we can point out that if you survive a horrible natural disaster, you will probably be scarred for life and become a raging alcoholic or drug addict. The good news is scientists are smart and can probably figure out how to keep you from going through it again. Is this a happy ending? By our standards, yes. And if you enjoyed this episode, then please press that like button and consider subscribing to our channel. We're lonely. We need friends. Thank you for watching Bad Things in History.